teach you guys how to produce custard and liquid soup. Okay? I said, I'm going to be taking you guys on how to produce custard and liquid soap. I help you. Okay. I will start with the first time, which is what? The custard. Quiet. Please don't pay attention and help me.
Hello.
This is
custard and liquid soap. Custard.
You can move forward. Milk and sugar are the optional material we have for the production of what? Custard. It's not what? Compulsory. Without it, we can still have our custard. Am I communicating?
Yes.
Okay, then we'll go back to the procedure for what? Production of what? Custard. It's very, very simple. What we can just do within 5 minutes. The first thing we do, we sieve what? Our corn flour. Okay? Okay, we sieve the custard so we can remove what particles like the lumps. When we finish sieving it, you discover that you find out some tiny, tiny particles that are not good for the custard production. Okay, so that when you are taking it, you will not find things like seed inside or impurities. Okay, that's how we sieve it. Usually, okay, you do what? You sieve your corn flour. Thank you. Here, I presume that this is okay for the color I need. Some people cannot even add all these things. It depends on choice and taste, okay? Some people can even decide not to add this to their custard. They prefer to have it white. It just depends on it. It's a matter of choice, okay? But I believe in the market today, everybody wouldn't want to have something as plain as that, just white. The anxiety or the urge to take the stuff will be there. We don't make it more colorful and you know, tasty. Okay, that's why we usually use our egg yolk. Our banana flavor, you can decide to use any flavor of your choice to produce your what? Custard. You can use strawberry, pineapple flavor, and all of them to produce your vanilla flavor to make your custard. It's also your choice, okay? Properly to have even mixture. You mix them properly.
Please, if you are doing it for commercial purpose, is it hygiene to use your hands?
Of course, since your hands are wet, you can use your hands to do that. I can mix it properly. You can decide to use your spatula, your turning stick. But I think it's going to be wasting much of your time when you are producing a lot. So the best thing to do is you just wash your hands, dry it, and then use the hands to mix. It's very much okay. Okay, at this stage now, those optional materials I told you, you can as well add them to your mixture now. You can add your sugar to this very mixture we have here, and your meal to taste. Okay, those ones are to taste. You can add them and you still have your sweet and what, colorful custard. But without them, after producing your custard and you make the custard, you can still do what? Decide to add your stuff to it. Some people, if it's for commercial people, some people will not prefer you adding sugar to their custard because some people don't like sugar, okay? So you can decide to just package your stuff this way and you're good to go. And another way, you can decide to have two packages. That's of mixture of the milk and the sugar, and the other one will start the milk and the sugar. And you are good to go. You can market it, you can use it for your own self. I already have our custard. So, but before then, let's check the color of what we have. Let's see if it gives us the color we really do what need. Okay, just have to check mess. Okay, so this is our custard. We have a plain yellow one.
Hello. Like I told you before, this egg yolk is to taste. Some people may decide to do what? Add this whole stuff into this half kilo of what? Corn flour. And you have a color that is deeper than this. So it all depends on what you want to produce. How you want it to look like, okay? But I think I'm very comfortable with this color I have here.
Yes.
Okay, so we are done with what? Custard production.
I continue again.